Welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. In this video session, we are going to see about how to write your first shell script, okay, or first bash script, okay. So how you can start and what is the things you have to follow while writing your script, okay. So the first of all, so the best practice is to use that create one directory and keep all the scripts in some place to identify that which is the customized scripts, okay. Also you can add the path environment variable path to execute the commands directly without typing entire path. So that is the things you can do it. So now first of all, I'm just going ahead and creating one directory saying that which is scripts, okay. Looks like I do not have permission, so I'm just switching back to the root user and I'm creating the directory scripts, okay. I'm setting the ownership name, or else I can change the ownership to /root/scripts. I am changing the permissions to the scripts so that user and root can only be access the scripts, so other users cannot access. I can also give some read-only permissions to the others. So maybe any other user wanted to read these scripts, example, okay. So I'm exiting from the root user, and now what I'm doing is that going to scripts. So I'm using vi editor to create the script. You can also use any editor, maybe vi editor or nano editor or anything, you can use it, but favorite thing is that vi. So I'm writing my file name is that my first script dot sh. The script name should end with the dot sh because it's required to identify that the file is in a script file, okay. If you do not give also, it's okay, but to give dot sh would be always a best practice, okay. Now I am going into the insert mode. I am writing this first shebang, okay, /bin/bash. Why the shebang is required? Shebang is required that it is called as a shebang or the bang line. So it is nothing but an absolute the bash path. Whenever you are, whatever the scripts you write over here, which is interprets with the bash. So what happens is that if you write whatever below that bang shebang line, so it would be interpreted with the /bin/bash path. So that is the meaning of the shebang. The shebang is very important on the shell script. So because if your intention is that you are executing some scripts using the bash interpreter, if some of the options, as I said in the earlier, that the shells, types of shells, so in that shells, if you see that there are so many shells, so some shells to shell, there is a difference in options. If you mean that you wanted to execute some command, example, any command, then the same command may not work on the other shells, so your scripts going to be failed. That's why I say, so the shebang is important to write. Next, now you have to write some notes or some description that what is you are going to do on the scripts or what you are writing on the scripts. Example, say this is my first script in this shell scripting video tutorial, okay. So now what I'm going to do is that I'm not going to write any complex method. I'm just saying that whenever the scripts runs, it should say that welcome, okay, $user, whoever the user is logged in. So it should tell me that welcome, username. So that user will be replaced with the username, so that it say welcome to the user. Okay, your example say your present working directory is pwd. Okay, this is the reverse quote I used. Okay, echo, and now I am saying that today's date is date. I am passing the command. So this is my script. So this script is first I put over here the command, so this is not going to be executed. This is just a description. Whatever this command is added with the hash, so that is commented, which will not execute anymore. So echo welcome and dollar user is an environment variable which I am using over here. So this variable will replace whoever the user is logged into the machine, that username will be replaced over here. And I'm saying that your present working directory is pwd. I'm using pwd command, so it will show you that this is the present working directory we are using, and today's date is so and so. Okay, and you may also use something like this to identify. So my script is started, my script is ended, something like this, so that it should say that a better impression on the script scripting. Now this script can be used or executed using the sh. For example, say my first script.sh. so welcome username and your present working directory is scripts and date is Wednesday. All this so and so stuff will be shown over here. In the same way, we can also execute the scripts using the dot slash, but this should have executable permissions. Okay, u plus x, and now we can use my script dot slash my script. So you don't need to specify anything, sir. Whenever you are saying that slash the scripts, it by default we use bash interpreter to execute that values. Or if you use a perl shebang, then by default it use perl to execute that script. So if you do not use anything, it uses the current shell to execute the command. Okay, so this is, you can also use source command to execute the scripts, source or /sh, or you can also use sh command to execute the things. Again, I am going to my scripts, and I am going to tell you that what I have written, and I am going to check it out. So shebang, this is my first script in this shell scripting video. This is a commented line, so which is the notes, and my script is starts, and echo welcome, and the dollar user is the environment variable. I am calling that environment variable. Okay, and use your present working directory. I am saying that pwd is the command executed, so wherever you are, that pwd will show you that directory path. And echo today ladies, and I am calling over here is the date command. Okay, this is what going to be happen, so which will execute and tell us that our first script is completed and executed successfully. So stay tuned for more updates and more videos coming up. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to the channel. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.